Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. My name is Dustin. I am a principal engineer SST in the systems management space. Today, I will be showing you how to enable debug logging in OpenManage Enterprise. So to get started, to enable debug logging, you have to go to the VM console or the text user interface. In VMware, this will be done through vSphere. And as we can see here, in vSphere, we can open up the actual console itself. And in Hyper-V, it's a similar function. You would also find your VM, and you can actually just double click it, and that pulls up the console or the text user interface. And once you're in here, you just simply go down to Setup Debug Logging. You choose Enable Debug Logs. It does ask you to restart the services to actually get them. So once you're here, you'll press escape to go back a screen. And we can then restart services. And we'll go ahead and just restart them all. And what you will see is some text float through the screen, and that is normal. And once those services are done, we can go to our GUI and see that the debug is actually enabled. So now that the services have finished starting, we will go to our OpenManage Enterprise appliance. And sometimes it can take a moment for after the services start for the actual UI to come up. So now that the UI is up, we will log in. And the idea here is once we're logged in, we'd want to first recreate the actual issue. As you can see, there's a banner that lets us know that debug lock is currently enabled. And if we want to stop it, we have to use the text user interface to do so. So what you do is you would reproduce whatever the issue was that was happening. Once that issue is reproduced, you would go to monitor. You'd go to audit logs. This is how we're going to actually gather the debug logs once we're ready to get them. And we choose export and export console log. These are the ones we want, and we can just save that file for review. We can also export audit logs, but that's only just exporting this actual list right here. So that's it. Now you have debug logs enabled, you have reproduced your issue, and you've gathered the logs. Now you would just disable debug logs, and you would be set. Thank you, and have a wonderful day.